Court of the Vile Gangster is the quintessential bounty hunter objective. From the Enhanced Jamma's Palace set, it's a deck that adds to your bounty hunter's forfeit and downloads bounty hunter ships. It also happens to be my personal favorite dark side deck. The first thing you need to know about Court is that more than just about any other objectives out there today, you do not want to flip. Flipping the objective gets rid of the ability to download independent starships, as well as the bonus to bounty hunter's forfeit. If you find a flip Court deck that you like, let me know, and maybe we can have you on bad deck breakdowns. Since you don't want to flip, you need to be careful about escorting anyone with the handful of capture-oriented cards that will likely be floating around in the deck. So now that you know what the deck doesn't do, what does it do? A typical deck starts Power of the Hutt Virtual, Jabba's Haven, and Battle Order and First Strike combo. Until recently, it would start Wipe Them Out, all of them, but Power of the Hutt helps against Leia Rebel Princess, who for more than 20 years has been the bane of this deck's existence. Power of the Hutt also pulls the new Hutt Influence V, which provides some additional hate for I Must Be Allowed to Speak. On your first turn, you'll use Jabba's Haven to download Nalhutta. There is an argument against taking this action in certain matchups, where Lightside has exactly one system, but Power of the Hutt V changes things a little bit, as its anti-Leia text only turns on when Nalhutta is on table. Try both ways when playtesting and decide for yourself which is better. While you're looking for Nalhutta, check the deck for Jabba the Hutt V, Scum and Villainy, and any docking bay. Assuming they're all there, download Jabba with the Audience Chamber, who then downloads Scum, and then use your objective to download a docking bay. If you don't have a Rebel Barrier, Stunning Leader, or Greedo in hand, and don't have enough force to back up Jabba, you may want to consider whether it's safe to deploy Jabba alone. In the current meta, I would say it usually is, because even if Lightside comes down and kills Jabba, it's unlikely they'll have enough force to cancel Scum, and you likely have a handful of characters just itching for a fight. Speaking of Scum, Scum and Villainy is the engine of the deck. Every time you initiate battle, you retrieve 2 force, and all of your aliens are deployed minus 1. You can see why Lightside would want to cancel it. I don't want to spend too much time going over specific card choices, as a few key cards from set 21 have drastically changed the way the deck feels, and at its heart, the deck is a good stuff deck. You want all of your ability to be provided by aliens or independent starships. You used to need to play enough droids to get around Leia Rebel Princess's text, but that's not the case anymore. There are probably a handful of droids that still make the cut though. Otherwise, just play the good cards, play the good bounty hunters, play the good aliens. Play the good droids, play the good ships. A few quick thoughts on matchups. Mains can be tough because you're both playing good stuff decks, but they usually have access to more powerful characters. If things go well for them, they'll fight you at the Audience Chamber until they win and can cancel Scum. Keep in mind all the ways you have to get characters back, and remember that the deck can win without Scum. If they get greedy on turn 1, don't be afraid to decline Destiny and set up for a counterbeat. If they deploy too early to the Pit of Carcoon because they're afraid of losing one force to your objectives ping, make them pay. Basically, take advantage of any mistakes that your opponent might make. Against 2 theater decks like No Idea or Quiet Mining Colony, they'll often ignore the Audience Chamber, so don't over-deploy there and instead try to win in space or just fight them on their turf. One final note, I don't think Court is quite there right now. Maybe it will get some help in set 22, or maybe there's a card nobody's playing that could make it tier 1. That said, it's consistently seen at least a little bit of play for as long as I've been playing the game, so it's definitely worth learning. Good luck, have fun, and no reverts.